Ladies and gentlemen, to my right, wearing the silver and blue, Miss Santana Garrett. And to my left in the green and fishnet, Miss Taylor Hendricks.
Certainly two of the most high-profile competitors that we've seen on The Secret Show so far. We've got Taylor Hendricks. She's going to be going one-on-one with Santana Garrett. Of course, Santana Garrett has been tearing it up all around the country for well over a year right now. She's been training longer than that, but she's really come to prominence, really blown up in that period of time. And of course, Taylor Hendricks, who competed with TNA over the last year. Actually, a competitor from my neck of the woods, up in New England originally. Certainly got some of the best training in the world, and he's going to be looking to implement that at the expense of Santana Garrett.
I'm excited for this match, too. If you look carefully, you'll see referee Chris Levin going through puberty, and there's a nip-up from Santana Garrett.
That's the type of stuff that makes people not want us to have the CW commentary team for the high pay-per-views.
I'll go back to my technical prowess here.
Yeah, man, you know how to wrestle. You're a wrestler.
Taylor Hendricks here trying with the nip-up to reverse the pressure on that wrist lock, failing miserably. Garrett switching to an armbar here. Locking in that shoulder joint, putting pressure on the neck, controlling the arm, turning her face down on the mat. Ooh, she follows up with a knee strike. That is legal in our rule system here. Chris Levin very tediously checking that. Staying in control of the arm there. Hendricks not enjoying this one bit, trying to find her way back to the top. An arm drag takes her back down to the mat. Able to avoid shoulder contact to the mat. There's Taylor Hendricks just close enough, not quite, to get those ropes. Hendricks, hey! Hendricks there with a unique counter of her own, finding a little bite out of that move. Finds the knuckle lock there. Controlling her with that knuckle lock here. Garrett trying to remain standing. Kind of hard to keep your balance with this move if it's applied correctly. Uh-oh, she's got the ropes. She reverses the pressure, drags her through, keeps the arm, able to get back to that arm drag.
Nicely done.
I'm in pain. I don't want to talk to you right now.
That's a good point.
Garrett just kind of laughing at her opponent there, staying in control. A little cocky there. Oh, got caught with a hip block. Hendricks, though, almost finding a Fujiwara armbar, not able to get that arm hooked. Uh-oh. A little payback, smashing that wrist, that hand right there. She gets back to that arm, locks in that arm bar.
There we see her trying to pull the arm away from the rest of her body at the point of the shoulder. No? Quartering? Once again with the snapmare. We've seen that maneuver effective in multiple matches, and a kick right to the chest. Even with the leg hooked, this match too early on.
Looks like Garrett's not playing around right now. Now trying to go for that more high-impact offense. Center to the corner, misses the turnbuckle. Hendricks counters, goes for that arm drag. Garrett wisely hang on to that rope. That would be a break if the referee got in between, but instead, controlling the arm, back down, gets a Fujiwara of her own. She triangles to try to get more leverage. Hips off the mat. That is a submission predicament. Will she give up? This move is a bar. It's all leverage there, using her entire body to control that joint. Hendricks just inching closer to those ropes. Can't she grab the ropes? Referee calls for the break.
We got a clean break. Honestly, she could have held that onto the five count, perhaps even longer. I don't know if the official would have called a disqualification. He's been pretty loose with the rules so far tonight. And once again, back to the arm. Sound strategy. Not in the same position where she can apply that submission predicament, but keeping her opponent grounded, perhaps planning out her next point of attack.
For smart wrestlers, it's a game of leverage right here, and it's very hard to precisely administer these holds. Garrett now climbing up the ropes of an escalera, finds an arm drag of her own, just whipping her across the ring. Hendricks really feeling the pain here. Garrett trying to cut that ring off. Smart wrestling out of Santana Garrett, the girl from New England.
Now with that Russian leg sweep, no wasted motion, floating right over into the pin. Easy for me to say. And Tal Hendricks is out of here. She doesn't want no more. Hooked by the back of the trunks. Oh! Caught her right on the ear. And maybe she was playing possum. Maybe she was looking to lure Santana Garrett into her trap. And unfortunately for Santana, she fell for it. Now Taylor Hendricks just stalking her opponent. Walking a full 360 degrees around her before raking. Oh!
Claw.
And now choking
stomach
too.
Claw, yeah.
I think Taylor Hendricks has had enough here.
Look at the aggression out of Taylor Hendricks now talking some shit.
This is your gut check.
Oh! Well, perhaps some pent-up aggression out of Taylor Hendricks looking to take out on Santana Garrett.
That must be what she calls that move that she grabbed her gut. She grabbed her in the gut there for a second. Is that the name of the move?
The gut check?
Yeah.
No, I think that was just like she was using her nails to try and just dig away. I don't think there should be a name for that because it should be it's an illegal hold.
Oh, I didn't get that reference.
What's it gonna be?
This guy with the jokes. How disrespectful, just paintbrushing her. Oh, just slapped her in the face. Oh, and stomping away. Now trying to choke her on the rope for added leverage. And using every bit of that five count to her advantage. Tell the fans here to kiss her ass.
I love it so much. I'm gonna do it.
Any volunteers? Choking away once again, risking disqualification. And enough is gonna be enough. Chris Levin needs to put his foot down. He can't be intimidated by these athletes.
Taylor Hendricks about to put her foot down there. Oh, nope, taking control of the legs, trying to pull her away from the ropes. Ooh, slamming her down. Garrett should not have hung on. So we beat one. Two,
only a two count.
Yeah, I don't know how many people know this too, but there's a lot less give closer to the corner.
Well, that should be common sense. These ropes do add suspension to the ring, which are supposed to aid in the impact of the blows here we see. But really, it's just a ring so that people can see it, kind of like boxing. Instead, closer to the corners, more less suspension, less give.
Yeah, definitely the way that professional wrestling has progressed as a sport. We do see a lot of the athletes using the ropes to their advantage. And right now, Garrett, instead of getting to the ropes to break the hold, using the hip lock takeover to find some separation. Oh, but couldn't capitalize on the opening she created for herself. Instead, got kicked and shoved right down to the canvas. I don't know. This is a lackadaisical cover. Excuse me.
Big words.
First time talking. I think I'm doing pretty good. Now with that modified surfboard. Oh, now she's got both feet applied. Tell you what, if you separate a shoulder, you're not going to be using the arm for the rest of the contest. That's going to be a trip to the hospital. Oh, and now look at that, moving the positioning of her feet. She's still pulling the arms back, but instead, just trying to cut off the flow of blood to the brain. But by doing so, Santana was able to find herself in a position where she almost had her opponent pinned to the mat. Normally when you see an exchange like that, the opponent has to give up the hold because they're in danger of being pinned. But give Taylor Hendricks credit, not only was she able to kick out, but now she's transitioned into perhaps a more effective hold. She said she's going to stay in this position all day. She ain't going anywhere. The shoulders are down to the mat, at least a quarter to Taylor Hendricks. She says she can see it. Conflict with referee Chris Levin. Oh! Now just bringing the heel across the midsection of Santana Garrett. The lethal legs of Taylor Hendricks.
Lethal legs brought to you by Raisin Bran. A great way to start your day.
Does cereal even need to get advertised? All right, Anita the Head. I hate Drew Kulak.
You booked me.
You're just bitter because you didn't win the Queen and King of the Ring, pal.
I don't want to talk about it.
Oh, how disrespectful, blowing her a kiss. But it looks like Taylor Hendrick has her fair share of supporters here at WSU. It's slapping her. Ah! Santana turned the other cheek. Wasn't expecting that kick to the midsection.
Could be the opening that she needs to get back to her match. She's going to regret smacking her.
Yeah, went to the well one too many times. Not sure why she tried it again, missing with the leg drop. on two consecutive attempts. Now Santana Garrett with that Oklahoma roll. Her opponent stacked up. Close to beating her right here. Now Taylor Hendricks, she needs to be worried about her opponent behind her instead of jaw jacket with the ref. Because she was 1 second away from being pinned. Shooting the double leg. Now that jackknife pin. Great execution. I think this is where we need to give credit to Taylor Hendricks, even though her antics have cost her the opportunity a few times in this matchup. She's certainly proven to be very resilient as she's trying to weather the storm here from Santana Garrett. Garrett out of the way, connects with a slap to the face. Oh, the super kick right under the jaw. Now, off the ropes, right in the moonsault press. Big victory out of Santana Garrett. Very impressive showing against Taylor Hendricks.
Ladies and gentlemen, your winner in 10 minutes and 32 seconds.